Lynda Cromar, and I'm happy to talk to you again today. I have been off a while because things have been kind of a wreck, trying to get my cold gone so that I'm not coughing. And I'm using this picture to share kind of I had a rant going on my blog, and I thought it would be a good idea to share in person what I'm feeling and why, and help you out, because you know what? For me especially, the little guy really, really matters. And I hate it when I see people not being treated well. And unfortunately, a lot of the time, people badly. And so I wanted to share with you some of my own thoughts. If I could get this on the, there it is. Okay, there we go. So I want to share some thoughts with you, and thanks for all the hearts, and welcome everybody that just now joined. And so part of my story is that I've been involved with probably about 10 different MLMs. Now, what I mean by MLMs, that's just another way of saying network marketing. The old school network marketing companies that unfortunately a lot of them are set up to reward the ones that have large groups and not help the good little guy. And I've always been sort of for the little guy. I care about the ones that really don't have a lot of budget and want to build really as much as any of the others that are actually trying really hard. And, you know, can you give a shout out for me? I will give anybody a shout out, Mike. Absolutely. But I want to explain to you why I feel this way. Many times when I've been in different things, I have been in things. Are you in Lion? I don't know what that means. Are you talking about the ick? You're gonna go away. Sorry. Anyway, we don't need stupid behaviors like that. Wait, what? We don't need a troll. Thank you. Bye, bye, bye. Okay, troll's gone. Oh, we gotta have a few of those, don't we? Shakes it up and makes it a little bit more exciting. But anyway, I don't have anything as far as a particular company that I'm going to rant about, because I think most of them start out with the right attitude. They all care. But the thing that I'm seeing happening, let me adjust this because it's hitting my volume and leaving that up. There, hopefully that fixes it. Anyway, a lot of the time they start out with, I'm not going to name names because I know that lots and lots of people are in different ones, and I don't think it's right to bash a particular company. Just in general, and it's actually more about the individual people that are involved and how they behave. Sometimes that can actually be the real reason that there's a problem. Like, for instance, the every 4 months jumping from one to another. Welcome, 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 everybody. And there's so many companies out there, there's no way I'm not talking about anybody's company. So I'm talking about, in general, the behaviors that you see inside by a lot of the leaders or so-called leaders. Some of them will say they are, and then they sell you all kinds of stuff, and then they get you so upside down that you don't even know which end is up, and then you never make any money. And that's not cool. I don't like to see that happen to anybody, because I've had that happen to me. Well, sometimes it's a lack of effort, and sometimes it really is that they don't know how to do it, and they need good training. And that's where I come in. I try to help you get better at the skills. We teach especially the internet marketing side of it because, for instance, like I said, I'm not going to name names. There are some companies that are bad. There are some that are really, really good. And I don't know all of the companies and what they do, so I'm not going to go there. If you want to do that, you can find somebody that's absolutely knows all the details about that. I'm talking about behaviors. Behaviors are important to understand. what kinds of things a particular comp plan or even a particular group of people will drive a certain kind of behavior. Many of the people start saying that they want everybody to push for recruiting. And then that leaves you in a place where you are constantly pushing. Yes, absolutely. That's what it means. And then that leaves you kind of hanging because you have people quit as fast as they join, because sometimes they believe something different about the product or the company than what maybe you may have shared. So it's real important that you're completely upfront with people so that they understand what it's about and what they're expected to do. And another thing is that you need to make sure that you're making it an equal. Oh, another troll. Thank you. You need to make it equal between product sales and actual recruiting, because actually what has happened is a lot of the time people think it's only about recruiting, and recruiting does not maintain your income for a long period of time. And if you have a lot of people doing that, you're going to have people that drop away real fast. But if they start loving your whatever your product is, and it doesn't matter, you're in a lot of people are in all kinds of different things. And that's okay. You can, yes, thank you. Absolutely. Stand up for what you believe. That's really important. So it's very important to have a balance, right? A balance between actual customers that are buying your product, whether they actually share the opportunity or not, and then people that are recruiting as well as buying the products. If you have a balance like that, you have a better chance of making it work. And that's really, truly the most important thing, is that you need to have that balance. And they're not teaching that in most companies or in the different leaderships that might be in that company. Now, a good leadership will teach both ways, and that's what you absolutely need to find, is if you're going to be connected with anybody at all, make sure your leadership needs to have a balance between a product and the recruiting, not both. And another thing that you probably don't know is that when you are promoting this on an internet, you really have to have a sure knowledge of what's acceptable and what's not with your company, because you can get in trouble if you're using their name when they have it specifically in their rules and regulations that you're not supposed to do that. And I bet a lot of people don't know that either, is that a lot of the time people are sharing their company names all over the place and branding themselves with their company name and not knowing that they're actually not supposed to do that. You're supposed to be a separate representative, and you're not supposed to use the name all over the place, because they don't give you permission to do that. They have it, what do they call it? I forgot the word, but actually they have legally set aside that name for their own brand of that company, and you don't have the right to use it unless they give you permission. Yes, absolutely. I do want to help you to understand, you know, because everybody out here, everyone that's in this hangout right now, or this broadcast with me right now, you're all involved with different companies. You're all trying to do the best you know how with what you have. And that's really, truly important that you do understand what's right and what's wrong. And one of them is that you need to have the behavior of both product sales and recruiting, not just one or the other. Now, product sales by itself will give you some immediate money, but it won't give you the long-standing money that you're looking for, the residual. And the recruiting will give you the long-standing, but if you don't do anything to get that person excited about the company's product, then that person is going to go away real quickly. And unfortunately, that very last one I was in did exactly that. They were real heavy on the recruiting,
and not very heavy on the products. And then at the very end, they decided, oh, I guess we better do better with the products. And they added a whole bunch of new things that they didn't actually have enough support to keep it going. And they lost big time, and it caused them to actually have to fold their doors. So you don't want to see that happening either. So you want to have the right behavior, and you want all your downline to have all of the right behavior. So I wanted to tell you that I am a member of what's called Simple Freedom. It's an affiliate program, but we have four different types of income. And one of them is the residual income that everybody here is looking to get. The other part is the immediate sales. You need to have the immediate sales too, because if you don't get the immediate sales, you don't have any cash flow, and it takes longer to build up enough of the residual that it creates the income that you're really looking for, because all of you are looking to eventually replace the income you now have from a job or some other source that you have had in the past. And so you're looking to replace or supplement where you are. And so you need all of those incomes. In fact, there's four different kinds of incomes that you actually need. You need, number one, you need an immediate small sale. That could be a product. That could be a training. In my case, it's all, we have trainings. We have a product called Envirolyzer. Hello from Scotland. Thank you and welcome. And thank you for the hearts. I really do appreciate that and I love it. So number one, you want an immediate front end sale that is small enough that people will generally say yes to. In my case, I have a product called Envirolyzer. It is $25 one time, and it lets you get enough training that you can actually be on the internet and know how to market in the right way. And it's actually 10 times the value that's in that one product alone. Then we have another one that's the same. It's one time of 150. It's a little bit more intense. It's all of the social media how-tos and setting yourself up right and branding yourself in a way that you can actually build whatever you want and do it long-term. And then we have another one called Alliance, and it's a monthly program in which they're teaching you about how to market, and they're giving you actual packages of marketing material so that you don't have to do it all yourself and come up with all the ideas all by yourself. And I love that one especially. And then we just came out with a new one that is the high ticket, and those are the four ways that you can get paid. And most really good MLMs will also have at least four different ways that you can get paid. But most of those other bonuses happen later on, and everything that I have can happen right away. So that's the major difference, and that's why I offer what I have. But I'm not really putting down MLM, but I do put down the behavior, because the behavior drives whether they stay or whether they go. And you want people that get excited enough about not just the opportunity, but the product, that it's good enough that it keeps them coming back to it. And it keeps them reordering every month. And then you start to have the stability that you need. And that's where you start to have what you need in your business. Because you're not wanting to reinvent it every single month and start over from scratch every single month. That hurts, and that's hard to do. And most people give up at the end because it's just so hard to keep doing it, to overdo it over and over and over again. And so that's what I had to share with you today. And as always, if you want to learn more about me, you can connect with me over on Facebook. Oh, I didn't get it. And you can find me at lynda.cromar and a number one behind it. That is my personal profile on Facebook. If you do connect with me in Facebook and you ask to be friends, please make sure and send me a message also saying, I just saw you on Periscope and I'm connecting. And then I will say yes immediately. And I really appreciate all of the hearts. I appreciate all the great comments. And we got rid of three trolls, and that was awesome. And I hope you're having a most awesome day. And we'll be talking real soon.